What would you do for love?
Anything.
Such a brave little creature. I'll take it from here.
So those damn horses have not been coming home until the following day. I don't know where they've gone.
Nice of you to join us, my dear.
Josephine, are you feeling better?
I've certainly felt worse.
So, the poor thing was so tangled, we were forced to shoot it on sight. It was all we could do to cure the poor thing of its ails.
Well, it certainly cured the countryside of its screams, at least. I don't think I've ever heard such a pitiful sound.
Tell me, is there a known cure for arrogance?
The anguish of men knows no bounds, Josephine. I've been a hunter's wife for the longest time. You'll get used to it. I know how uncomfortable you are around dead things. I've never really minded them.
I care a lot less than I used to.
So did you retrieve the creature or leave it there?
Well, you'd think I'd almost eat anything, but you'd be mistaken. Besides, it was suffering badly and it was infected.
This is hardly dinner conversation, dear, and poor Margaret is feeling a little paler for it.
I just can't bear the thought, that poor horse.
Isn't it amusing that people are expected to suffer things that we would never dream of allowing the noble horse to endure?
The horse is indeed a noble creature. Which is more than could be said for most people. Present company excluded, of course.
Yeah.
That's quite right. I've never met a horse I didn't like. Hunting is not something I care for, but I do relish a ride through the countryside. It's the freedom, the open air. There's nothing like it.
Yes. Women are strange creatures indeed, my friend. How best to control her tongue? I think her tongue could serve you more graciously in numerous ways. Best be wise, my friend. I speak from personal experience, lot of personal experience. The joys do not outweigh the complications. This house has no secrets. I know all of your secrets. Every last one.
Maybe it's time you remembered who you're speaking to.
Is everything all right, Your Ladyship?
Some mornings, these walls can seem a little closer.
Are you all right? Do you need anything?
No. Get out.
I don't understand.
What's there to understand? Leave me be.
But I love you.
Love? Oh, you silly you. You know nothing about love.
I know that I love you!
Then that, my dear, is your misfortune.
Given the unusual circumstance, will you be dining alone this evening, my lord?
Absolutely not. However, the lady will take a meal in a bedchamber.
Very good, sir.
Where is she? Where is she?
I don't know, I swear!
I can't believe it, George. Am I the only one that isn't entirely surprised that something like this has happened? The only real surprise is it didn't happen sooner.
I don't think there's anything I can do, even if you did have something to do with it.
My dear Byron, she didn't talk to her friend.
don't have to tell you how it looks.
No, you don't.
I'll do what I can, and then you're on your own.